In this Nuage tutorial video, we're here at beBlue Studios, and I want to talk to you about the speaker configurations for Atmos mixing. There are basically two different minimum speaker configurations you need to have, depending on the type of Atmos mixing you're doing. For home theater mixing, it's required that you have a 7.1.4 speaker configuration. Now, let me describe what that is. The first is the 7. 7 speakers are in the horizontal plane, and we start with the left, center, and right speakers that are behind the screen. Then we have a left side surround that's to the side of you, and a right side surround. And then in the back of the room, we have a left rear surround and a right rear surround. That's the 7 speakers. Then the 0.1 is the subwoofer, the low frequency effects channel. And then the 0.4 are the 4 ceiling speakers, front left ceiling, front right ceiling, rear left ceiling, and rear right ceiling. So that is the 7.1.4 configuration. And that's the minimum for home theater mixing. Now, if you're mixing for cinema, the minimum configuration is a 9.1.4. Basically, it's the same speaker configuration with the addition of 2 channels in the horizontal plane, and that's a left wide and a right wide. So going from the front, you would have a left speaker, a left wide speaker, then the left side surround, then the left rear surround. That would be one side. You would have the same thing on the right hand side, one low frequency effects channel, and then the 4 ceiling channels. That is a 9.1.4 configuration. Now here at beBlue, we have an 11.1.4 configuration with the addition of two extra rear side surround speakers. So here we've got center, left, wide left, left side surround, left rear surround, or I'm sorry, left surround, and then left rear surround in the very back. So you have the same complement on the other side that gives you 11 channels plus the low frequency effects channel, and then the 4 ceiling channels. So that's what we have here at this studio. And we're able, with that speaker complement, to be able to author for both home theater and for cinema. Now today, we're working on the fractured film, and we're rendering this for home theater in Dolby Atmos. So there you have it. Those are the speaker configurations required for Atmos mixing. And we'll show you in other tutorial videos how to get started and actually do the work.